The spec is what you brainstorm on. We covered this last week. Spec, brainstorm. That's the document that guides the brainstorming, okay? Because that is the culmination of the population, the outcome, the problem, and how it relates to each other. It incorporates all those things and details your, what? Criteria for brainstorming, right? That's the guidance document. So what you want is you want to have your need and your need specification as a guidance to where you're going. Does that mean you don't allow yourself to go back and forth and kind of say, oh, we have to find this, this is not a... You got to find a balance between letting yourself free flow into ideas, but also being productive and stopping at certain times saying, let's time out. Let's take a look where we are. Are we kind of working with what we got here, or are we way off base some other place? Because then you can become more efficient as far as thinking where you're going. So I'm a believer in brainstorming where you follow your need specification. In other words, that is the guidance document that sets you up for the brainstorming session. Right? It doesn't have to guide everything you say. You don't go, okay, I was thinking maybe it could be made out of nitinol, for instance, my favorite substance, right? And then you kind of go, okay, let's check and make sure nitinol's okay. And we go up and look at our need specification. No, let it flow through ideas, but then I think what you want to do is a facilitator has some time checks and say, you know, let's stop for a second, let's take a look, see where we are. We've kind of gone off on this tangent. And then let's come back and see if we're on, because if we're so far off from our need spec, we're unproductive, right? We're not going to be working on anything. We're going to come up with a great idea, and it's going to be even harder to then say that great idea doesn't match up. Let's guide ourselves a little bit and find a balance.